Hello friends, today in this tutorial we will be building this Electron desktop application from scratch. So this is a media converter kind of a application. So I have built this application using the FFmpeg library, which is an open source library for handling the audio and video stuff. So this is the interface of this desktop app. So it is a complete version that I am showing you. Here you can select the format. I have just provided 4 formats, but you can provide as many formats as you want. Let me just select MP3. And now you will click this button of select file and convert. And now I will select into my videos folder. Let me select this short video. If I select this, you will see that a short alert box will be come up. And now the notification also come up that conversion completed. Your file was successfully converted. So I will also be showing you that how to use this notification. How to show this notification when the conversion process is completed. So now if you go back to the application, inside this folder there will be a media folder automatically created, and inside this media folder you will find all your videos which have been successfully converted. Let me now take another example. Now let me choose AVI format and click select file and convert. Let me choose the same file, and now you will see that again the same process is repeating. You can do this for any format. You can see that this is the AVI file that I have created here. So if you hover onto it, so this is MP3, this is MP3, and this last one is AVI. So now if you open this, just a 3 seconds of video is there, not much. So you can see that. So I think that this is a great application if you want to get started with using FFmpeg library and how to integrate it inside this Electron desktop application. So for this tutorial I am assuming that you have installed FFmpeg library. So in order to check that if you have this library or not, just go to command line, and here you need to provide it this simple command, which is FFmpeg. So if you write this command and enter, if this results comes in, then you surely know that you have successfully installed this library. So if you don't install this library, this application will not work. So let me just show you the website where you want to go to in order to install this. So just go to ffmpeg.org. This is their official website. This is a complete cross-platform solution to process the audio and video. So here you will click on the download button, and there are various kind of release builds are there for you. So depending upon your operating system, you can select window release. So if you click on this, you will be redirected to a next page, and here you can download the build version. So just static one, zip file is there. So click on the download button and your download will be started. And after that, there is a next process. It will automatically install this FFmpeg library onto your system. And then we can start building this desktop application. And all the source code of this desktop application I have given in the video description. This is the official GitHub repository. If you click on the link, you will be redirected to this GitHub repository. So here you can click on the download button and click on the download as a zip. So basically it will download your project as a zip file, and then you can follow along with the video. So let's get started by building this application, guys. Now to get started, guys, just on your desktop create a new folder. And inside this, you can just name this folder as Media Converter App, something like this. So after this, just enter into this folder and open command line. So the very first thing that we need to do is that we need to execute npm init-y. So this will create the empty package.json file for our project with the default options. And now we need to install Electron. So we'll install this command, npm install --save -dev. So this is a dev dependency. So after that, write Electron. So basically it will install it as a dev dependency. So it will not be coming when we build the project. This dependency will not be required. So it will just take some time. Depending upon your computer speed, it will install this module. Now you can see that, guys, this module has been installed, Electron. Now after this, clear the screen. Now we will install 2 more modules which are required for this application. First is jQuery. So we will be requiring jQuery. And after that, we will be requiring this random dash string module. So basically, in order to generate file names, random file names, we will need this module, which will be generating random strings for us. So these are three modules that we will need. After installing that, we can open this inside Visual Studio Code, our text editor. So you can use any text editor of your choice, but I will highly recommend that you use Visual Studio Code. So inside this, you will find a package.json file will be automatically be created here. You can see that alongside with the node modules. So if you open this file, you will see that this will contain the information about your project, name, version, description. And this is a main file, which is index.js. And one change that I want to make in this file is this script section. So inside this, we will write our start script. So here, the value will be electron space dot. So now I will just write npm start, and then it will start my electron app instead of writing electron dash. And now I will create my entry point file, which is index.js. So here inside this, we will first of all import electron. So the first thing that we need to import here is that we need to import our electron. So we will declare a variable for that, which will be app. And here we will be require electron. And inside this, we have this app property. You can see that dot app. So after writing this, we will be importing another module, which will be browser window this time, in order to create our window inside our desktop application. So again, for that, we will be requiring the electron. And inside this, we have this browser window variable. Browser window, you can see that. And now after this, we also need to create a main window variable, which we will initialize it to null early on. And just after this, guys, we need to initialize our window when the app is ready. So there is a app.on method, and this is a event name which is ready. So when the app is ready, this callback function will execute. And here inside this callback function, we need to initialize our main window variable, which is currently null. So here we will make use of the browser window module that we have imported. Let me just make it as capital B. So browser window. So in this, this accepts some options. So first option I will be giving is to resizable, and this window can be resized. So I will give true option. The second option is the height. The height I will give at 600. And the width will be 800. And the fourth option is how, in order to include node modules, we will be have to give this web preferences. And inside this, there is a property which is node integration. This needs to be true. So if you don't include this, you cannot use Node.js modules inside your Electron desktop application. So this is a very important property. This is a very mandatory one also. So if you don't include it, you cannot use any kind of external Node.js modules. And now we just need to create our index.html file that we will be putting inside our desktop application. So right here inside the app.on, we will be binding a main inside our main window. So main window dot, there is a method which is load URL. So inside this, we will pass inside double quotes file colon slash slash, because we are just be loading from the file protocol. And then we will be getting the dir name, which will return the current directory name. And then we will concatenate with the slash main.html. So now we need to create this file main.html inside our directory. So just create this main.html file. So here we can create the bare bone structure of an HTML document. So here you can give it a title that is media converter app. And for building this, guys, we also use some Bootstrap for styling purposes. So if you go to the Chrome browser, just type Bootstrap CDN, and the very first link which comes in, Bootstrap CDN, grab the CSS only, and right here, just make a link and paste the CSS. That's it. And now inside this, guys, we will have a container class of Bootstrap, and inside this we will have a heading which will be Media Converter App. And we will align this heading inside our center position. So give it a style attribute, text align to center. And we will also give two break tags from the top just to create some space. And now at this moment of time, when I run this application by executing npm start. So now if I run this, hopefully you will see a page. This index.main.html file inside my desktop application. So just wait, it is running this Electron application. So now this is my Media Converter app. So hopefully you will see the HTML rendered out on the screen. So this is a menu, and you can see that this is a heading which is Media Converter app, and now the application is successfully running. So now let me just close it. After this, guys, we also just go to index.js. After you load this, we also need to make sure that we release the memory once the main window has been closed. So we will be attaching a closed event also. So main window dot on, we will use again the on method, and this time there is the event which is closed. So when the main window is closed, we need to release the resources. So this is garbage collection concept. So inside this, we just again want to make sure that main window is set to null. So there is no point using the memory when the main window is closed. So we are just initializing it to null. That's it. And now going back to main.html, we will write the rest of the HTML code. And just after this heading, we will be having our select box. So div form group class or Bootstrap, and inside this we will have our label for this will be for the format. So the text will be simply select format. After that, this will be colon, and after this, guys, we will be having our select element. So I will not be giving a name to it, I will be giving an ID to it of format. And there is a Bootstrap class of form control, just to make it look pretty, form control. And inside this, guys, we will have some options, four options. So option first will be mp3, so don't have to provide value here, just in the label mp3. Then the second option will be our avi. The third option will be our I think we have pickup FLV, and the fourth one will be MP4. As I told you earlier in the video also, you can take as many options as you want, but for the sake of this video, I am just taking four options. So FFmpeg support all the video types, you can look at their documentation. So just after this div here, guys, we will have a break tag, and after that we will be having a simple button which will be having a class of btn block, just to make it full size, and btn danger, which will be giving a red color to it. And the label will be pretty simple, which will be select file and convert. From the name itself, it will automatically select the file and automatically convert the file also. So it will do the two things at one time. And I will be giving an ID to it of upload. So that's it, guys. This is, I think, is the HTML. And one more thing, just after the button, we will be printing out the info as well. So just give it this div ID of info. So here we will be populating the alert boxes, just telling the user that your file has been started converting. So just wait. So this info we will be populating inside this div automatically. So after the body, guys, as I already told you, we also will be using jQuery. So first of all, we need to include the script file that we will be writing, script source, and we will be giving a name to it of renderer.js. So specifically, I'm giving this name as renderer or .js because of the processes that are involved in order to make Electron desktop application. There are two processes there inside Electron: main process and renderer process. That is why I'm giving this as renderer.js. Now we just need to make this file renderer.js. So inside this we will write our custom JavaScript code. Now guys, inside our renderer.js, first of all we need to bring our button, which is document dot, we can use document dot get element by id method, get element by id. So we have provided this id to it of upload. I don't want to use a hash symbol, just we can write upload. And after that we need to add a event listener. So button dot add event listener. So when we click this button, we need to make a simple function, callback function. So inside this function guys, first of all we need to show this dialog box where we can select files. So for making that dialog box, we need to use a concept of Electron, which is IPC, which is stands for inter-process communication. We need to first of all communicate to the main process that we need to open this dialog box. So for communicating it, first of all we need to import a special module which is there inside Electron right at the very top, so which is IPC. So it is there for both the renderer and the main process. So here I will import it IPC, and this is there inside the global module of Electron. So require Electron and dot, we will use the IPC renderer module. You can see that IPC renderer, just grab this, and now with the help of this IPC module you can send events to the main process. So we can use IPC dot send. So here you can write any name, unique name of your choice, but I will be giving a name to it, name to this event, which is open file dialog for file, just a descriptive name so that we can recognize it inside our application. Now we just need to go to the main process, which is index.js. Again we need to do the same process, import this IPC which is there inside Electron module, and this time this will be IPC main. That's it. Now we need to listen for this event which has been come inside, we have passed this from the renderer process. So this is IPC dot on. So here the event that we have made, this open file dialog for file. So I will just copy this name here. So this is a concept, this is inter-process communication at its core. So now the event will be there inside this event variable. So this callback function will execute. First of all we can just console log on the screen something that, just to check, I will just log out that button pressed. After this guys, we also need to open the dialog box. First of all we need to compare the operating system. As you know that Electron is cross-platform, first of all we need to compare the operating system. For comparing the operating system, we also need a module which is OS. OS is built-in module, Node.js module, which is require OS. So with the help of this module we can compare the operating system. Operating system dot, there is a method inside this which is platform. So inside this platform method we can compare it. So if it is Linux and or this is OR symbol, or it is we need to again use the platform method, or if it is Windows, so Windows stands for Win32. So this needs to be 3 equal to signs Win32. So in both of these cases we need to show the same dialog box. So in order to show the dialog box, first of all we also need to import a dependency which is dialog. So here inside this we can declare dialog, and inside this guys we will make use of destructuring. So just write var, inside a double curly brackets write dialog, and this is, we will fetch this inside from the electron dependency like this. So now guys, we will be showing the dialog box. So there is a method, it is there, dialog.show open dialog. So this is a method. So inside this guys, first is the window. So here you need to pass null. The second option is it takes some properties, so a set of curly brackets. So inside this there is a properties value which you need to initialize. So this is an array, so here we will pass open file. So this is a constant value that you need to pass. So F needs to be capital, and this returns a promise guys. So in order to handle the promise, we will use dot then, and inside this the result will come in result. So this will be an arrow function. Sorry, this needs to be arrow function. And now we can return out the path of the file. So first of all, we can just console log the path. So we can just write result dot file paths. So basically file path is a array. So array of, if you select multiple files, this is kind of an array. But in our case, we are only selecting one file. So we need to pass the first element of the array. So in order to pass from main process to renderer process, we will use this event. And there is a method inside this, which is event.sender.send method. So with the help of send method, you can select any sort of information. So first of all, you need to provide a specific label. So I will provide the label as selected file. And then we need to pass the value, actual value, which is result.filePaths. So as I already told you, we need to pass the first element in the array. So inside the square brackets, we will write 0. So this will pass the path of the file, and we can even catch a error like this if any kind of error take place. We can, let's suppose, console log this error. So this is only done for these two operating systems. So if your system is Mac or Apple, in that case things become slightly different. In the else block we will write this use case. As is, it is not mandatory because my system is Windows, but I will show you, because if your system is Mac, then in that case you need to follow this approach. So in that case, this method will be simple, show open the dialog. Let me just copy paste the, all the things will be the same, just a property will change. So I will just copy paste this code, paste it, and here inside this properties it will also have a option of opening a specific directory. So you can even open directories in Apple or Mac if you don't know. That's it guys, the rest of the things remain constant. So this is our code here. Now we need to catch this event that is sent to us, which is selected file. We need to catch it inside our renderer process. So now in order to catch this, it is pretty simple. We need to receive this event, so ipc.on. So the event name is selected file. So this will have a function, callback function, holding the event and also the path as well. So just receive two options, event comma paths. So now we can first of all console log the event just to check. And after this guys, we can just console log the path as well. So console log the path, which is there, paths here. Now in order to just to check if this is working or not, I will execute my application by executing npm start. So now hopefully it will console log the path of the file that we select. So this is the application, you can see that. Now basically I need to select file and convert. If I press this button, a dialog window will appear here, you can see that. If I select this file and open the developer tools, toggle developer tools, in the console you will see that the path is there. You can see that C users kiki videos and .mp4, and now it is also showing it inside this console also, button pressed, all that stuff. So now we know that this is working. But the one thing I have noticed that the button is not appearing good. It needs to be red color. So I have made a mistake inside my HTML. Let me just see. This needs to have space in it. That's the problem. Now if I check here, if I rerun this application, npm start. So now you will see the button also looking in a good fashion. So I think class btn, oh so this needs to be space also. So I'm just committing some mistakes here. So at the end of this tutorial, so just forgive me. So again, if I execute this application, you will see now the application is looking good. Select file and convert. Now we just need to hook up the functionality of executing a simple ffmpeg command. So the next process we need to do is that we need to get the we need to declare some variables. So just after this upload, we need to declare a format variable. First of all, we will initialize this format to mp3 by default, and also we need to create a directory of media, because inside this directory we will store all the files which get converted. So we will be giving a path to it of directory. So the idea is that when we launch the application, we need to create this directory programmatically. So for that, we will use the file system module which is there inside Node. So you need to require the fs module. And after that, you can just use this method of fs dot. First of all, we need to check that if the directory is already available, then in that case, we don't need to create it once again. So in for this, we have this if condition, if exist synchronously. So we will pass the directory. And if the directory already exists, in that case, we need to make the directory. So with the help of this function, make directory synchronously. And we need to pass the path, which is directory, that you can see. And now what you will find, guys, if I execute this for the very first time, this application. So it will create this media directory. So just notice, if I execute npm start, on the left hand side, it will create this media directory. So you can see that it is automatically created for us. So this is the use case of that. And all that converted files will be there inside this media directory. So now we need to get the format that the user selects from the select box. For that, we have given a specific ID to it. You can see that for the select element, we have given this ID of format. So now inside renderer.js, we will write a jQuery code. First of all, we need to include jQuery. So const dollar symbol. And we need to require a jQuery that we have installed, jQuery module. So now inside this, guys, we will write first of all target it's by the ID, the select element format, and there is a change method. So if the value changes, this event will trigger automatically. So this will expect the callback function, and inside this callback function, we need to reassign the value to the format variable to whatever the value that the user selects. So here we can do that by format dot space the option colon selected. So whatever the option is, we need to now use a text method. So basically it will be getting the text which the user select, and it will assign it to format variable. That's it. And after this also, we need to re-execute the ipc.send method again, because we need to send the open dialog once again. So open file dialog, sorry, file dialog for file. Guys, this line was not present inside this format. You need not have to write this line. So just delete this. Only we need to assign the format to its value. So now after that, guys, we need to execute the ffmpeg command. let me just show you the command that we will be using inside this project. So if I go back to command prompt, so there is a command here which is ffmpeg dash i. So dash i stands for input. So here we will provide the input file, let's suppose video.mp4, and space, then we provide the output file, which is, let's suppose, output.mp3. So this is a simple command that I am using here in order to convert the files from one type to another. So this is a simple command. Now we need to execute this command programmatically using command line. So for that, we will use a very famous module, which is there inside Node.js, which is the process module, child process module. So as you know that Node runs inside a single process, but you can even create child processes as well. So with the help of this module, which is child process, so which is there inside the Node as a built-in module. And after declaring this process, now inside this selected file event, so now when we got the path of the file, we need to execute the conversion command, execution of conversion using ffmpeg command. So here we will use the process again, process dot, and inside this there is the execute method. So inside this execute, we will pass the command which I have shown you. So here I will make use of the backtick symbol. So we will write the command, which is ffmpeg dash i. So here we need to provide the input file. So input file, we need to surround this inside double quotes. And here we need to write dollar, a set of curly brackets. So this will be a dynamic value, which we have given here, which is paths here. You can see that. Paths. So now we have got the input file. Now we need to just give it a value for the output file. So for the output file, we will be, as I already told you, all the output files will be going to this media directory. So here we will write media slash and then our value for the output file, so which we will be creating from the random module. So there is a random module that we have constructed inside package.json. You can see that random string. Now we need to include this module. So now at the very top, we can include this module, const random string. We need to require it, random string. This is a module. So after this, now we need to use this. So here we will pass a random string. So this is a function which returns a random string to us. Now we need to concatenate something after this. So we can concatenate, let's suppose, you can concatenate anything, but I will concatenate underscore video. That's it. So this also have a callback function also. So the second argument function, and this returns three arguments, which is error. If any kind of error take place, the second is the standard output std out, and the third will be standard error std err. So just pause the video and just understand this crucial part of the video. So here, first of all, we are executing this ffmpeg command on the command line programmatically using Node.js. And first of all, we have provided this argument. This is the ffmpeg command, and then this is a callback function. So here inside this, guys, first of all, we can console log the standard output that we are getting, std out. And then, guys, what we can do here is that we can check for any kind of error. So if any kind of error take place, so if error is not equal to null, so in that case we can also print out the error like this, console log the error. That's it. Sorry, this needs to be error. So now the application is almost complete, guys. So now if I execute this application, let's suppose if I start this, so where is my command prompt? So this is a command prompt. If I now execute npm start, so now if I select the format, which is mp3, oh sorry, one mistake I have done here, I don't provided the format, so which after the video, this is the name of the output file, and here dot, and then we also need to provide the format. So again, dollar, a set of curly brackets. So here we need to provide the format variable. So this will get the dynamic format. So the initial value is MP3, but the user can change. So here we can write format. That's it. So now if I once again write npm start to start my application, you will see I can change the format, let's suppose, to AVI. And now if I select file and convert, if I select this file, you will see inside, you can see that this file has been converted and automatically being generated inside this media folder. If I check, let me just go to my directory. This is media, and if I open this 3 minute video, you can see 3 second video. So now you can see that. So now we have successfully converted video from one form to another. So now we just need to add some slight touches to this video. We also need to add a alert box telling the user that you are converting the video. So now inside this, we can create a dynamic variable. We can target the ID that we have given inside main.html, this info. So we are just targeting it by the ID info, and we need to append something to it. So we will use the backtick symbol. So here inside this, we will use a div, give it an ID. Sorry, let me just first of all write the classes. So this will be a alert, bootstrap alert, 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 success. We need to also close it. So now inside this, you can say the name of the file which is there inside $paths is converting. So please wait. So here you can just customize this application whatever you want. You can change the text, but I am just giving you the concept. So after this, appending this, we also need to make sure that once the I think this needs to be shifted here. Just copy this, and here we need to write this. So just paste it here. So this means that when we just press the button, then this alert box will automatically come. So now when the operation is complete, so once the process is complete, so now inside this callback function, we need to hide it also. We need to remove it. So now in order to remove it, first of all, we need to give it a random ID. So here we will generate a random ID by the random string process once again. So here we will declare a random ID variable, and we will use the random string module once again. So basically this will generate a random ID for us. So here we can initialize this ID is equal to, then again dollar, and here we can pass random ID. That's it. So now guys, we can using this ID, we can delete this element also in jQuery. So this is the concept. So here we will select this ID, which is there. We will use the backtick symbol once again, hash symbol, and then random ID. Random ID. And then we will use a detach function in order to remove it completely. So there is a detach function in jQuery. That's it. So this will remove the element from the DOM, which is, and then if I just show you guys, if I rerun the application, if I close it, you will also see a short alert box also. npm start. So now if I select MP3, select this video, so now you will see that. So it has come for just 2 seconds because the video was small. It was come and it was gone. So now we can even add some break tag also, just to make sure that just before that, we can add some break tags to create some space. So now the last thing which remains is that we also need to show a slight notification to the user that your conversion process is completed. For that, guys, inside our process.execute, inside the callback, we will be using the notification class. So notification dot, and there is a request permissions method here, request permission method. And inside this returns a promise. We will handle this by dot then, and this has a callback function holding the result for us. So now we will create our notifications. So this will be my notification, and this will be, we need to create a new notification, and here we will give the text, whatever text you can give, that is title, conversion completed. And the second argument is a set of curly brackets. So this defines the body of the notification. So here you can just write that your file was successfully converted. So basically this notification process is pretty much useful whenever you have a large file, and this notification can guide you that your process was complete. And now if I run this, our application is complete now. If I just execute npm start once again, and let me just select mp3 once again, click on select file and convert. If I select this file, now you will see the notification also coming up, conversion completed, your file was successfully converted. You can just change this to this, whatever file, you can see that. So this was the complete desktop app that I have shown you guys in Electron, how to build it using FFmpeg. So thanks very much guys for watching this video. If you like this video, then please hit the like button, subscribe the channel, and also tap the notification bell icon. And I will be seeing you in the next video. Until then, thank you very much.